88,000 rupees.
A very good evening to all our viewers. It's Sunday the 31st of October and welcome to a brand new edition of Primetime News coming to you live from our News First studios in Colombo. I'm Arundhati Mudal Nayaka. Let's start off with a look at the stories making headlines this evening.
The Chinese vessel carrying rejected fertilizer enters the Sea of Sri Lanka. Government says the organic farming initiative was an experiment. Venerable Muruthettuve Thero explains what will unravel if the fertilizer plot thickens furthermore. The 11 government parties challenged to leave the government. Chinese ambassador to Sri Lanka concerned over a deal to supply 8 nuclear submarines to Australia. Final rites of Venerable Velamitiyave Kusaladamma Thero, who rejuvenated Buddhist education in Sri Lanka, carried out today.
Now for the stories in detail. Vessel trackers are indicating that the Hippo Spirit ship carrying substandard fertilizer from China has in fact entered the Sea of Sri Lanka.
The fleet on vessel tracker indicates that the Hippo Spirit ship carrying substandard fertilizer from China has entered Sri Lankan waters. It had updated its data yesterday. Previously, the tracker showed that a ship named Seyo Explorer, bearing the same identification number of the Hippo Spirit ship, had entered the seas of Hambantota. However, the port from which the ship had left for Sri Lanka remains unclear. Vessel trackers confirmed that the ship was heading to Sri Lanka from the Malacca Strait on the 13th of this month. On the 24th of this month, the ship was spotted 44.82 nautical miles off the Hambantota port. The ship was also seen 4.18 nautical miles in the seas of the Yala National Park. However, the ship had gone out of range after that. News First made inquiries from the harbour masters of the Trincomalee and Colombo ports in this regard. They said the radar systems don't indicate the position of the ship.
Meanwhile, pressure is being exerted on Sri Lanka to unload Chinese fertilizer containing harmful bacteria from a ship near the country's waters. The Chinese High Commission had blacklisted the People's Bank for failing to pay for the fertilizer stock after opening letters of credit. The bank had not made the payments to the Chinese company while respecting a court order issued on that matter. The People's Bank pointed out that international regulations relating to letters of credit should comply with the country's domestic laws. It added that the bank has acted in line with the laws with regard to the letters of credit.
දැන් දේශීය ගනුදෙනු කරුව වගේම විදේශ ආයෝජකයෝ ඒ වගේම විදේශීය ගනුදෙනු කරුව තුල මේ සම්බන්ධයෙන් තියෙන්නේ විවිධ මති මතාන්තර. මහජන බැංකුව විදිහට මොන වගේ පණිවිඩයක්ද මේ ගනුදෙනු කරුවන්ට දැන් දෙන්නේ?
ගරු අධිකරණය විසින් ගන්න තීරණය මත තමයි.
The future action of the People's Bank regarding the letters of credit will depend on the court order. We open letters of credit under the international guidelines called UCP 600. It is a set of regulations that has been accepted by the business community. It should always comply with the domestic laws of the country. Whether we can make the payments or not depends on the country order. But as the entity which opened letters of credit, the People's Bank has a responsibility of making the payment. A decision will be made only based on the court order. We have decided to convey our stance to the Chinese High Commission. Regardless of what the court order is, I believe that we should be removed from the blacklist of the High Commission based on internationally accepted regulations.
The final rites of the Kalaniya University's Vice Chancellor, Venerable Dr. Velamitiyave Kusaladamma Thero, was held with state honours today. This was at the Independence Square in Colombo.
Mm-hmm.
The remains of Venerable Dr. Valamitiyave Kusaladamma Thera, who passed away on the 27th of this month, were laid for public respects at the Kalaniya Vidyalankara Pirivena. The remains of the late Thera were brought to the Independence Square in Colombo today. The final rites were carried out with the attendance of the chief prelates of the three sects and other religious leaders. Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa, opposition leader Sajith Premadasa, representatives of foreign missions, commanders of the tri-forces and members of the Buddhist clergy were also present. Education Minister Dinesh Gunawardana delivered the condolence message on behalf of the President.
The Vidyalankara Pirivena is a religious and academic institution that has continued to produce Buddhist monks who love the country. The Venerable Thero was able to protect the dignity of that institution and take the name of Vidyalankara to the world. Venerable Kusaladamma Thero stood with us when we were in power and also in times of happiness and sadness. While his exemplary personality taught us many lessons, I wish to remind you that his advice was a great strength to us. The Venerable Thero always stood for patriotism. He advised governments on protecting the country's unitary status, territorial integrity, sovereignty, and political freedom.
The final rites were held at the cremation chamber afterwards.
More headline making stories come your way on the other side of this short commercial break. Stay with News First. We will be right back.
TV One News First, main sponsor.
Students complete the ACBT University Entry Foundation in 8 months for 288,000 rupees.
Do your online shopping with Sambole.lk. Home delivery and pickup now available.
Sambole.lk.
Bellboy's got you covered. Download Bellboy today to get all your household appliance fixing and repairs done. Now available on Android and iOS.
Welcome back to the news. Minister S.M. Chandrasena says the decision to ban chemical fertilizer was done as a trial to implement organic fertilizer in the country.
It was an experiment that we have carried out this year. If the results are not favorable after it is implemented during the Maha season, we requested the president to allow the use of both chemical and organic fertilizers during the next Yala season. But to do that, we need to conduct a trial first. It has been 15 days since water was released to paddy fields for the Maha cultivation season. But farmers continue to stage protests, demanding chemical fertilizer. The hunger fast launched by the Farmers Collective of Alahara in Moragahakanda entered its 8th day today. Farmers are demanding a quick solution to the fertilizer crisis. This government was elected to power to fulfill the hopes of farmers, but all those hopes have died. We don't have fertilizer. Fertilizer is there in Anuradhapura. Duminda Dissanayake has intervened and given chemical fertilizer to corn farmers in Anuradhapura. Why can't they give fertilizer to us? We are requesting for at least half of the fertilizer that we require. Meanwhile, a religious ritual was held at the Minneriya Devalaya in Siembalava, demanding a solution to the fertilizer crisis. The Alhara Farmers Association had organized the ritual.
තාම නිසි ප්‍රතිචාරයක් ලබා දීලා නැහැ. අපිට මේ දුක්ගනවිල්ල කන්නලව්ව වෙන කියන්න කෙනෙක් නැහැ.
Parliamentarians, ministers and officials assume that farmers are cows. We are not cows. We are intelligent. Therefore, we are requesting them to provide the required fertilizer, weedicides and pesticides to cultivate freely as we used to.
තව මාසෙකින් දෙකකින්
We will have to be in hunger if this situation continues to exist. These rulers can go to countries like the US and the UK. The innocent people will have to stay in hunger forever. A protest march took place opposite the Sri Kavantissa Purana Rajamahavihara in Ambilipitiya, demanding fertilizer. Farmers who cultivate banana, fruits and vegetables have been left helpless. Give us what we need, otherwise we will surround your mansions. We wish to tell President Gotabaya Rajapaksa that it isn't too late. Reverse this decision as well, just as you have reversed your other decisions. When the children of the innocent mothers and farmers who earn a living through cultivation are affected, don't the rulers of this country who make foolish decisions understand their problems?
We aren't asking for relief from them. We are asking for fertilizer. Ultimately, we won't have anything to eat. Our children won't have anything to eat either. Farmers weren't the ones who looted the central bank.
It is reported that not a single farmer in the Ampara district cultivating under the Galloya movement have received any fertilizer as of yet. It has been 16 days since water was released from the Senanayaka Samudraya for cultivations in the Maha season. However, many farmers have already abandoned their lands. This was the state of Kiripattiaya in Mayadunna. According to our correspondent, farmers have used all the fertilizer they have to cultivate for the country instead of using fertilizer for their own use.
We were the ones who brought this government into power. Now we have had enough of them. We cannot stay in our homes now. There is no point in expressing our sorrows to the president or the agriculture minister. It was the prime minister who asked us to vote for this government. Therefore, the prime minister has to intervene in this matter and send one of his representatives here. They have to set foot here and see the situation for themselves.
Farmers say although 5,000 rupees were promised by the government to purchase fertilizer, farmers have only received 3,000 rupees. They said some farmers have not received any money at all. Some farmers have managed to purchase compost fertilizer from the money they have received from the authorities, but the Department of Agriculture has not yet certified the suitability of the fertilizer for usage.
Meanwhile, Venerable Muruthettuve Anandathero expressed his views on the repercussions of not managing the fertilizer crisis properly.
Why are the farmers protesting on the streets? What is the purpose of this? The government must inquire into this. I am asking them to go for an election. We don't have to go any further to understand the situation of the government and the pulse of the people. The government makes a decision in the morning and revises it in the afternoon. The decisions they make in the afternoon changes at night. The cost of sugar, milk powder and gas were increased suddenly. There are queues for cement as well. The leaders haven't paid attention to this.
The Chinese ambassador to Sri Lanka has raised concerns over the AUKUS deal in which nuclear submarines are to be supplied to Australia. He says China believes that nuclear weapons should be completely prohibited.
Chinese ambassador to Sri Lanka Kee Zhen Hong has raised concerns over a deal to supply nuclear submarines to Australia. The US, UK and Australia had recently announced the establishment of a deal known as AUKUS. The deal would provide Australia with at least 8 nuclear submarines. In a statement, the ambassador said the deal is similar to holding up a sword of Damocles on countries in the Pacific Indian Ocean. He added that the AUKUS deal has increased the threat of the spread of nuclear weapons. The ambassador called the deal as a violation of the Treaty on the Non-Proliferation of Nuclear Weapons. He argued that this creates a new arms race, which will undermine regional prosperity and stability. He added that this also shows the double standards of the UK and the US, which are part of the deal. The statement said the US and Britain don't allow Iran and North Korea to possess nuclear weapons while ignoring the nuclear weapons development by Israel and providing nuclear submarines to Australia. The ambassador said China believes that nuclear weapons should be completely prohibited, but he added that China has always maintained its nuclear power at the lowest level.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi has invited Pope Francis to pay a visit to India. The invitation came after Modi shared images of his first private meeting with the Pope at the Vatican. The Indian Prime Minister is attending the G20 summit of major world economies being held in Rome. This is seen as a significant turnaround after negotiations for a papal visit to India failed in 2017. The last Pope to visit India was John Paul II in 1999. While international activity within the Sea of Sri Lanka is increasing, leaders of some countries are strengthening geopolitical ties with other nations. Against such a backdrop, the National Bhikkhu Front says the country has been exposed to risk as national assets are being given away to companies of powerful nations. They came to power to protect national assets. The government, which said they would recover the assets that were sold, are selling national assets while diverting the attention of the people from that. The president can't say he is not a member of a party or the cabinet. If that's the case, why is he there in the first place? He earns using public funds. The president must at least have the responsibility of providing a clarification on this. He hasn't spoken about this yet. He is being silent by doing what he wants. No one has the power to do that in this country. Meanwhile, 11 government parties have opposed the deal to sell 40% of shares of the Kerabalapitiya power plant to US-based New Fortress Energy Limited. Various views are being expressed on this matter in political circles. If government parties are performing the role of the opposition, they must switch sides. They can't remain here. If they are leveling absurd allegations before the entire country, we will have to make a decision on that. The party will be undeterred by that. If they are planning to move forward by criticizing the president and those in leadership roles, we will allow them to do that by switching sides. We won't allow them to do that while being on our faction. Why are they doing this while being in the government? They will have to leave this. If this continues, they have expressed their views. I don't feel that expressing one's views will lead to a crisis. After leaving, with whom are we to join hands with? There is no one. We can't predict what would happen in the future. It is not good to damage ties during this period. The country is not in a good position. The only option for a group having alternate views is to leave the government. If they leave the government, there are 14 members of the Sri Lanka Freedom Party. They will also leave the government. They will gain nothing by remaining in the government without leaving it. I am asking them to leave the government. The government will have to leave if we join hands and surround them, just like the farmers are protesting. That day is not too far away. Remember that there is a limit to the patience of the people. If people take to the streets, they will end up in the US and not anywhere else. A cabinet proposal was put forward regarding that. They could have expressed their views at that time. I believe it is wrong to make statements in other places instead of using that opportunity. Acting like this will bring disrepute to themselves. They are criticizing the government which they formed. Whether they stand with us or not, we stand with the work plan of the government. If they have a backbone, we are challenging people like Minister Vimal Veerwanse to resign from their positions. Please resign from your ministerial positions. They say they are doing this to push the government on the right track. Do they have to express critical remarks openly to do that? They don't have the backbone to do that. If they have the backbone,
Please name the people while accusing them. We don't know whom they are referring to.
කොන්දක් තියෙනවනම් නම කියලා කියන්න අපි දන්නෙත් නෑ මේ කියන්නේ කවුද කියලා ඉවරයි. ආප්පේ දැනගන්න ඕන තාච්චියේ හිටපු විදිය. ආප්පේට ඕන විදියට තාච්චිය හැසිරෙන්නේ නැහැ. තාච්චියට ඕන විදියට ආප්පේ හැසිරෙනවා මිසක්.
When they had no support and when they were trying to build their party, they created a new platform with the support of small parties. The group that is trying to discard us were the ones on that platform. That is the platform on which the Podujana Pyramid was born. Therefore, if anyone is trying to conduct themselves by forgetting that and attacking those with different views, they are destroying their own political journey. We have seen that in the past. Finance Minister Basil Rajapaksa obtained blessings from Venerable Palle Gamahemarathana Thero, the chief incumbent of the Ruanvali Mahasaya. Finance Minister Basil Rajapaksa also obtained blessings from the chief incumbent of the Mirsavitiya Temple, Venerable Ethelavattanavave Gnanathilaka Thero.
While politicians continue to focus on issues within their political parties, people of Hambantota are facing difficulties due to the poor condition of a bridge in the area. The bridge used to travel to the Attanayala village in Madamulana, which is home to about 400 families, has been in a dilapidated state for almost 2 years. Although authorities had begun constructing it following requests by villagers, the project has been stalled at present.
යන්න කිසිම වෙන පාරක් නැහැ. මේ පාර කැඩිලා දැන් තුන් හතර දෙනෙක් ඇවිල්ලා මේ හදනවයි කියලා ගිහින් තියෙනවා. මේ ගමට එන්න යන්න මිනිස්සුෙකුට හැටියන්නේ. අපිට ඕන මේ පාර කොහම හරි.
The only request of villagers of Attanayala in Madamulana is a bridge to ease travel.
Justice Minister Ali Sabri says he wasn't consulted when the presidential task force on one country, one law was established. He had told the Sunday Times newspaper he wasn't happy about the move.
The Sunday Times reported that Colombo Municipal Councillor Khalil Rahman had learnt about his appointment to the task force on One Country, One Law through the media. He had claimed that he was not informed that he would be appointed to the task force. Khalil Rahman had been elected to the Municipal Council from the United Peace Alliance. Its party leader Bashir Sheikh Dawood said the party would take disciplinary action against Rahman if he chose to accept the position. The New Wings movement expressed their views on the establishment of the presidential task force appointed to study the implementation of the concept One Country, One Law today.
We see this as an attempt to secure the power that is slightly slipping out of their grasp. Who are they representing? There is no representation for the Tamil community. The female percentage of the country is 52%. Is there a name for woman in this list?
කාන්තාව ඉන්නවා කොහෙද මේ ලයිස්තුවේ කාන්තාවක්ගේ නමක් තියෙන්නේ
එක රටක් තුල එක නීතියක් ක්‍රියාත්මක කිරීමට නම් මේ රජයේ
What should the government do to implement this concept of one country one law? First of all, they have to stop tampering with the judiciary. Secondly, they have to stop the influence they exert through the Attorney General. The Attorney General has withdrawn many cases filed against the Rajapaksas and their close allies. This government that has failed to accomplish these two tasks are trying to establish one country one law. That is not the rule of law.
අපිට එක රටක එක නීතියක් ලබා දෙන්න උත්සාහ කරනවා. ඒක නීතිය ආධිපත්‍ය නෙවෙයි, ඒක අනීතියේ ආධිපත්‍ය.
Three press groups are preparing to set up a people's tribunal over the killing of three journalists. This includes Sri Lanka's Lasantha Wickramathunga.
Reporters Without Borders, Free Press Unlimited and the Committee to Protect Journalists will set up the People's Tribunal. It would be to indict the governments of Sri Lanka, Mexico and Syria for failing to serve justice over the killing of three journalists. They include Lasantha Wickramathunga, Miguel Angel Lopez Velasco and Nabil Al-Sharbaji. The tribunal will begin hearings at The Hague in Netherlands on the 2nd of November. People's tribunals are created to generate a record of evidence to hold states accountable. They also aim to raise public awareness of high-profile incidents. Reporters Without Borders said evidence of the unsolved cases relating to the deaths of the three journalists will be presented to a panel of judges. Nobel Peace Prize winner Maria Ressa will be among those delivering testimonies. Lasantha Wickramathunga was serving as the editor of the Sunday Leader newspaper when he was assassinated. He was killed on his way to work on the 8th of January 2009.
The year 2021 has been challenging in terms of cybersecurity. It reminds us of how we can keep our cyberspace safe and secure. News First Ruha Zaid Fan files this report as October is recognized as the month on cybersecurity awareness.
Do you use social media?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah. Yeah.
Where social media pavichi karanoda?
Oh, pavichi karana.
Yes.
Oh, social media vel innoda?
No.
According to Statista, there were 10.9 million internet users and 7.9 million social media users in Sri Lanka in January 2021. Social media users in Sri Lanka increased by 1.5 million between 2020 and 2021. Sri Lanka CERT is the country's national agency for cybersecurity. It says 5,938 cases of cyber harassment were reported from 2017 to 2020. Nearly 80% were done through fake accounts.
How much of your personal information have you stored online? Maybe your birthday, your identity card, or even your bank details. And I'm pretty sure after the COVID-19 pandemic hit, every single person in the world and in the country would have used social media and digital space even more. But are you sure that your data out there is safe and secure? And are you aware what you can do when your data is misused? If you face some kind of cyberbullying, are you aware what you can do?
No. No. Maniware monari karana.
Danne. I
don't. E pilibandawa danon karana ona ansha wala danuwat karana.
No ideas like that.
Really we are not aware regarding that.
What can you do if you are a victim of cybercrime?
So if you are victimized by a computer crime, you can go to the criminal investigation department and file your action. Complain them. They have different departments, the financial fraud department, the cyberbullying department, and computer crimes department. So you can go and complain them. If you are bullied by way of a penal offense like sexual abuse, you can go to police and lodge your complaint. If the police is not acting, you can go to the magistrate court and file your own action and take the criminal arrested against that crime.
Are new laws being prepared on cybersecurity?
So the latest reforms are the cybersecurity bill. It's already been drafted, and also the data privacy bill, which protects processing of data, and Defense Cyber Command Act, and the reforms for electronic transaction.
Cybersecurity is a very shared responsibility, and it comes down to a very simple thing. The more systems we secure, the more secure we all are.